Next, I'm going to introduce how to warm up sake. The most sure and traditional method of warming up sake is to put sake into a heat-proof container, such as tokuri, a kind of sake decanter, and warming up with hot water. Tokuri, the sake decanter, should be filled about 90%. Don't fill it full, sake bloom increase when heated. And here's the important thing. Cover the mouth with the plastic cloth so that the aroma won't escape. Test with your tokuri by placing it in the water to ensure that approximately half of the tokuri is immersed. Heat water just before boiling point. You'll see small bubbles rising to the top. You also can boil water in a kettle and pour hot water into a container. The key to heat sake is to immerse it briefly in hot water. If sake was kept in fridge and the temperature was around 42 degrees Fahrenheit, it will take a few minutes to be warmed up to around 104 to 113 degrees Fahrenheit. Touch the bottom of the tokuri, and if it's relatively hot, but you still can press your finger, the temperature of sake will be just right. If it's so hot and you cannot touch it no more than a few seconds, perhaps that's overheating. I don't really recommend you to use microwave to warm up sake because microwave makes its temperature uneven and increase rapidly that it's hard to control. But if you really need to use microwave, I'll show you some tips. Wrap the mouth of tokuri and take it out and swirl it every 20 seconds. If you are to warm up ichigo or sake, it takes about 40 seconds at 600 watts to make nurukam. Once you learn the deliciousness of sake, you'll even find the corners as the best spice. So, wonderful autumn with hot sake. Cheers!